there's Gary has like playlists in here. He has like Gary playlist, a jiu-jitsu playlist. Here, what's you put on Gary, and then he has some stuff.
Dude, I tried this before. Like, our top just to see where it took me, and it took me right into that kind of my back and what they're making stroke.
Yeah, that's
what
I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's like
I don't know, yeah, but it's right here.
Trigger.
I think so, because I'm thinking I got to get ahead of it.
I might drop this.
But you got it. Yeah, just
press the button.
Posture up. bike that's my leg. That's giving me this, it's making my knees pain. You'll see this a lot, right? I feel comfortable, right?
Yeah.
But once over my hip, I start to lose it. I'm over. It's right there. It's the hip man.
Better position.
Thank you.
have it though.
Oh, that's the thing. John
will have the code. Yeah.
I love it. If anything else, it opens the door for like other stuff.
Yeah, I might have to reposition my base in order to cross it.
Yeah, I'll think about beginning together,
but fuck, it was a scramble. You guys are more fun. It's 2-on-1. Very, very good.
Dude, yeah, it's such a strong hold.
So, my turn, I'm trying to control your wrist. I'm like, okay, I'm going to pull that wrist.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Holy cow!
Yeah.
Okay, let me try one more time.
I don't know how to.
Rescue.
Rescue.
Yeah, second.
Yeah. Yeah.
different type of leverage.
There wasn't anyone there.
these balloons. They're watching me.
Now what I'm trying to do, what you want to do from here,
I gotta quit looking at that book before I reach for it.
So I'm trying to remember the idea of that I'm posting out, which gives some space. Anyway. But it's this, not just leaving your leg loose, nice and tight, and then using it as a lever. And even if go ahead and start to pull it out, there. So if I get low, what they call corner guard, I can still walk up there. And I can still. I can still kind of leverage your right. I got sweet.
It's not as easy as that when you're dealing with people who really know what they're doing, but getting the half guard and then at least being able to protect yourself like I did, hide your head. Control the arm, get the waist, and then try right loose right there.
This is not guaranteed for sure.
This is so weird.
You have a low ground up here.
So you want. Think about digging your elbows in and then if it's right from just cover. You're lifting your head up so you don't have to move your elbows. See, I can't get up high on you. Now you got me almost. Now you're here. Now climb down my knee. So, now what you do, you feed that in, you can go. Okay, there you go. That's a good one. You got me on the other side, but that's all right because they try to roll me on my back. Right? I got this. This is that. See, look how you got space. Way down low. Because I can't choke you when you're down low. You have to be able to shoulder yourself. But see, I could strike you here. I've got some videos on the half-court thing on how to get out. Trying them. Okay, let me try this.
That was deep water.
The key is not bringing your hands to here, it's bringing your head.
Bring your head up,
to that.
Well, you're not supposed to have your head down.
Quarter guard, yeah. There. That's where I learned the wizard too, is from dogfight. Anytime somebody's going for your back, if you get that,
I'll instinctively kind of do that if someone's near. I'll even just try to try to get a guillotine, even if I can't get it, just to stop their head so they can.
Okay.
Yeah. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Let's go ahead and do it again. I want to show you. You do the escape, and I want to show you something that.
I want to figure out. coaster of emotions.
There's a lot going on there.
I'm in the same boat. My advantage is So now, go ahead and just put a fist there, right against my shoulder. So now,
both my hands are two. Yeah, come on.
Now start scooting up. Yeah, I can't get out. That's what I'm gonna do. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this. Okay, so that's the defense from that. If somebody does this, it's going to be, arm, I got it. Nice. You get the wizard, but that's going to reverse it. Right. So that's pretty simple. Somebody posts that, and we're just going to grab that and collapse it. Go
first.
Right? Yeah. Because that's our basic. Crap and roll.
Yeah.
The arm there, you've got all crap right there. And they got the weight on it, so I go to here.
Is there like a really strong weight trap?
Right at the elbow, right? Because you want to put the elbow to my hip. So pull it. The more you get it, the more my elbow goes to here, the more my weight goes forward.
Uh-huh.
And the more easy it is for me to roll. So
when you get all your weight on it.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah, and just go for the. Yeah, there you go. Nice. Now you've got break the guard.
I suck at that.
Oh, not too bad. Yeah, you can round your back a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, if you're clenched in like this, this is the way that you're shaving your hair is just that. Just shoving your knee in here. Because I have the center and it pushes up the leg out. So you want to try that. You put it clenched in here. What you're going to do is switch your stance. And that one's in, right? And then just drive that knee into the side of my knee. Yeah, yeah. And then just push. Don't try to push my upper body. Just push my knee. And then there, and it's going there. You do that, and then see, I go down. There was a point that it pushed me past my center, and my weight was in. The key about sweeping somebody is whatever leg you get the other weight on, they can step. If they're even, they can make a step. If you get all that weight on there, then you can either get the one that's light. Especially, you don't want them to.
That's why I don't like this. I haven't got bad yet. I've got
rock.
And not only just like making it easy to shoot, but you can practice it all.
Yeah.
And then if your bot is right where to the spot, and you can double.
Yeah.
And you can do that without even shooting. You can do that like
uh-huh.
a million times. And you get used to being reloaded and
okay.
dead on. And so you can practice like you're always practicing all.
So okay.
You do it over and over again.
Uh-huh.
And then for me, that's the best way. Like I said, you don't have to shoot any rounds.
Yeah.
You don't have to shoot the robot and slide it in. Like, you know,
well, Joe, the gal that comes from the Dodge, he's got a training gun with a red dot.
Yeah,
and so we played that a little bit. So,
yeah, I mean, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Actually, it's control, right? And you don't have
to make her four.
You squeeze, you know, you got to trip there.
Yeah.
Right? But if I'm fighting it, now you got to squeeze.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, this one is that. I'm going to get hurt too, which we can't hurt in my office, and I do have to shave down.
just, all you're doing is basically, you're basically
the more I drop my thumb up towards your armpit, I'm getting there.
Yeah, you have to reposition. Because you don't know that.
When they're
Right? Most people just like, oh yeah, I got this thing. You
know? I've been stuck there years.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was one of those. I was like, what are you doing?
How do I fix this? I think the person that talked to me, he was in a position where he was getting the money down. He didn't know it was a position. It was when I first met him, first of all. I don't think, dude, you got a lot of people in life for this girl. Now he's just like stuck. He's like car trash. Yeah, he got me with his leg. He leaned in from the garage. He almost had a crucifix. They made it put in my elbow.
Thank you.
that, that's kind of unintentional. So think of it. You can't be where the mic is at. So we're here to destroy that.
That's a better way to go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Alright, see you then.
So, all your weight's on your knees right now. Pinpoint it here like a three-legged table. Yeah.
Yeah, no.
So we're here. I'm framing. Keep this here.
Uh-huh.
Push. Slide down. Touch that knee. So when you go, yeah, because now it's on my neck. Now just drive your head to my head. Shift all your weight. Three leg table. More weight here. Straight down on this. Straight down with your shoulder. Yeah. So think about a table with three legs. So your legs are like one and two. And then this third leg and shift it all. Like you're gonna do a shoulder stand right here. Just, yeah, right there. Yeah, yeah. Now squeeze too.
When it gets tight on that mat, your shoulder's getting pressure.
Yeah.
information. I want to show you. Yeah. I was just showing him my collar tie, short chokes. Yeah, just fix the camera. No, I'm not going to put you in the seat.
I love this.
So, like, if I'm in a seatbelt and he starts hand right here, and I was telling him, like, my
oh, yeah. Up,
and your chin's tucked, I can't get under your chin. So, what I was telling him is I could just pop here. I'm already starting to feel my shoulder and my wrist on the side of his body, right? And I'm under his chin enough to where I'm like, okay. So I never loosened up on that connection. I'm thinking about it any time. I'm connected, and I'm just progressively connected.
Yeah, his fingers landed like right here at first.
Yeah, that's super low.
And he's fighting. Yeah. So I'm like, I'm spider crawling, I'm moving his head.
Yeah, if you can get the fingers like to get a bite, like you said, just spider crawl. Because all it needs is like a couple inches, and then you can hit that short jump.
Because when we go here and I start popping his head on, he's going to fight for this.
Yeah.
I'm going up, I'm going that way, I've got no strength. Man, I can't get any taller. Yeah, I can't add it.
The whole, I mean, I'm trying to tell him, like, it's not a big deal. It's like,
thought I was one of the lucky. And I go, no, I'm a white belt. And they're like, oh, you're up now. They've been calling you. Like, maybe a 16-year-old, 200-pound, that weighs 205. He said, we don't have anybody for you. We have no white belt to 205. And I go, okay. And he passed my guard and won this big old knot. Right? I'm not mad at the 16-year-old because he passed my guard and we look like two fumbling agents. So, I got my stuff and I told my wife, let's go. Like, I was born in Paris.
If I get this under, I gotta tuck my head here. Yep. And then take him over here.
Boom. Shove my knee over.
Yeah, shoulder. So here, yeah. And then tip my, they call it putting in a light bulb.
Yeah, so like, his head.
Here, I gotta keep it up on my shoulder. Yeah, when I'm belly down, I have a little more to add into it. I'll stick my legs out.
Don't let go of the legs until you're on top of controlling your body.
It's a good sweep. If they're flexible, you get on top. If they're not flexible, you get on top.
So,
and so like from the bottom.
This one.
Some of them are really, really nice though.
So, I'll show you that. Whip up and whip. Remember Whip Up, Whip Down? So, it's from Lockdown. I'll get here, and they're just really savvy to this. They got underhooked, so I'm trying to get this ankle. I'll whip up, I'll whip down, I'll go to this other hip. No, I'll get my underhooks. So I'm whipping up. Under here. I got my electric plugs, I got both. But I still can't reach. He's being a good, doing a good job whipping me. So then again, I'm going to pinch my knees, and my heel and my heels and my butt, and I'm going to kick my toes to the ceiling. I'm going to get here.
Oh, ow!
But sometimes I gotta fight those underhooks by doing the whip up. Whip down. Suck this in. Mm-hmm. Suck this in. Like a flex.
It's like kipping drill. You ever do the kipping drill?
Yeah.
Oh, the kipping drill. Sorry about that. Just,
everybody does that.
Yeah.
Yeah, sometimes. And that's what I mean. I don't do it for a lot of people.
It wasn't that bad.
No,
it was just like, it was an unexpected what's going on.
I try to be gentle with it. That's why I don't do it a lot.
Yeah. Well, as soon as I said, you were like, okay.